And I'd choose you in 100 lifetimes. I'd choose you in 100 worlds. I'd find you. And I'd say I do. For the rest of my life, with all that I have, I do.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the sight of God and before His church to witness the union of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. This is an honorable estate instituted and blessed by God in paradise before humanity's fall into sin. In marriage, we see a picture of the communion between Christ and His bride, the church. Our Lord blessed and honored marriage with His presence and first miracle at Cana in Galilee. This estate is also commended to us by the Apostle Paul as good and honorable. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into inadvisedly, or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for the mutual companionship, help, and support that each person ought to receive from the other, both in prosperity and adversity. Marriage was also ordained so that man and woman may find delight in one another. Therefore, all persons who marry shall take a spouse in holiness and honor, not in the passion of lust, for God has not called us to impurity, but in holiness. God also established marriage for the procreation of children, who are to be brought up in the fear and instruction of the Lord, so that they may offer Him their praise. For these reasons, God established a holy state that Chris and Bea wish to enter. They desire our prayers as they begin their marriage in the Lord's name and with His blessing. Our first reading is from Genesis chapter 1. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let him have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over the livestock, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth." So God created man in His own image. In the image of God He created him, male and female He created them. And God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over every living thing that moves on the earth." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our second reading is from Ephesians chapter 5. Therefore be imitators of God as beloved children, and walk in love as Christ loved us and gave Himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, His body, and is Himself its Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives, as Christ loved the church and gave Himself up for her, that He might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water in the Word, so that He might present the church to Himself in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This mystery is profound, and I am saying that it refers to Christ and the church. However, let each one of you love his wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our Holy Gospel is from Matthew, the 19th chapter. He answered, Have you not read that he who created them from the beginning made them male and female? And said, therefore, a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. The text for this sermon is from Ephesians chapter 5 that was just read. The institution of marriage was given to us by God. The Apostle Paul wrote, of course, with the help of God, that the estate of marriage is good and it is honorable. If we were to further define marriage as God designed it, it's the union between one man and one woman. It's a union that takes place, and it's a union that encompasses all. It's physical, it's financial, it's sharing in everything. Yet, that's not easy to do. So if you, being Chris, want your marriage to last, you must be imitators of God. Paul wrote, "Be imitators of God as beloved children, and walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God." There's no better example of love than what our Lord Jesus Christ did for both of you on the cross of Calvary. Being Chris, right now, you have this wonderful feeling about each other. You've waited for this day quite some time, actually over a lot of hurdles that were going on out there in the world. But as time goes on, you will learn that you both have flaws. You know, you're probably thinking, each one of us thinks the other one is absolutely perfect. But you will, in time, I can guarantee it, you will start to notice a few flaws in the other one. It can't be helped because no one is perfect. See, we all have flaws, but in many marriages, the flaws become the focus of the marriage. Couples start focusing on their flaws until the flaws are the only thing that can be seen. The result then is drudgery and pain. It's not a good marriage at all, and finally, the marriage comes crashing to an end. Our Lord Jesus Christ had no flaws. He was absolutely perfect, yet that didn't stop him from taking on the flaws of the world. He didn't let our flaws ruin his love for us. In fact, our Lord Jesus Christ died for each one of your flaws. He put sinful men and women ahead of himself. He kept his Father's will perfectly so that we could be forgiven. In your marriage, it's very important that you are imitators of our Lord. You need to understand every single day of your lives what our Lord did for you. He was perfect. Nevertheless, he loved you and he died for both of you. He took your flaws so that you could be forgiven, and so that when the time is right, you can be in heaven forever. Just think of what your marriage would be like if you both would be like Christ and love each other as he loves you. Just think how incredible that would be to look past each other's flaws and to be able to forgive every single day of your lives, to be able to hug each other and love the person for exactly who they are. That's what Jesus did for us. That's what our Lord did for us as he hung there on the cross. See, he went to that cross to die for all of our imperfections so that we could be saved. Paul wrote, "Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord." This is a verse that sometimes gets women pretty angry because they don't have the proper understanding of what the Apostle Paul was trying to say. What Paul was speaking about is not the way we view submission in today's world. It's not WW wrestling type submission holds. It's not that kind of thing at all. It's not for the husband to threaten his wife, for the husband to be cruel to his wife in any which way. But it's a submission of love. Again, to understand completely what this is, we have to look at our Lord Jesus Christ as our example, because there's nothing else out in the world that shows how great that is. See, in the church, we submit to Christ. We submit to Him because we know what He did for us on the cross. We know that He is a great blessing to us. We know how much He loves us and how much He cares for us. So naturally, by knowing what a wonderful Savior our Lord is, we love Him with all our hearts and are willing to do anything for Him. Paul wrote, "Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave Himself up for her." Chris, did you hear what Paul wrote? "Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave Himself up for her." Many husbands are very quick to go along with the submission thing, yet they don't want to be Christ-like. They don't know what love really is. See, love is all giving. It's the giving of everything to one's spouse. In fact, it's so giving that if you have the love of Christ, you would be willing to die for your spouse. See, it's an honor to be a husband. It's an honor to have a wife that will be with you. As we stand here right now, it's an honor to be standing here in the presence of God and to show our love to one another. Remember why God created Eve in the first place. He saw that Adam was lonely. He needed a helper, so now you have that helper. You can be with her all the time. She can take care of you and you can take care of her. She can help you as you help her. Yet if you want your wife to love you, if you want your wife to help you, you must love her like Christ loved the church and was willing to give everything up for the church. And so likewise, you must do the same. You must want to give up everything for B. Wow, just think of that once. I mean, if you just ponder what I just said, it's completely different than what the world looks like today, right? In the world, we're told that we need to ascend to the highest point, we need to be the greatest, we need to be the best, we need to be just the person on the pedestal. But what God says marriage is all about is working with each other, lifting the other one up to that height. And if they fall, being there to help them. It's so wonderful. It's so wonderful. See, a wife submitting to her husband because she knows that her husband will do anything for her. That's the whole point. If you're able to do anything for another person, they will be willing to do anything for you. It sounds too good to be true, doesn't it? It sounds just too good to be true. It sounds like some kind of fairy tale. But the truth is, it can happen. See, it can happen. All things are possible with God. See, you need to allow God to make Jesus first in your life. And when Jesus becomes first in your life, that love of our Lord Jesus Christ just flows out to the people around us. Being Chris, this marriage thing isn't about being legal, as many call it. It's about the blessing that God has given you. To be able to live together as man and woman, to share each other, to honor each other, to have children, and to love one another. What a blessing it is to share your lives with each other, all centered around the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, as you go forward in your lives, don't forget to be an imitator of God. Read God's word. Listen to God's word. Pray, praise, and give thanks. And with the help of the Holy Spirit, you will be able to place God first. And then as a result, your love will be able to grow. And your love will be able to grow and grow and grow. And as that love grows in God, that love will grow between each of you. See, the truth is, Jesus said, all things are possible with God, and your marriage is no exception. Amen. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Chris, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony as God ordained it? Will you nourish and cherish her as Christ loved his body, the church, giving himself up for her? Will you love, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain united to her alone so long as you both shall live? Then say, I will.
I will.
B. Will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony as God ordained it? Will you submit to him as the church submits to Christ? Will you love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain united to him alone so long as you both shall live? Then say, I will.
I will.
Please turn towards each other. Repeat after. I, Chris,
take you, B,
to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy will. And I pledge to you my faithfulness. I, B.
Take you, Chris.
To be my wedded husband. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. According to God's holy will. And I pledge to you my faithfulness. Jake, could you please bring the rings forward? Let us pray. Almighty Father, you have generously created all things to serve us for our good. Send your blessing upon this couple who shall wear these rings as a constant reminder of their marital fidelity. Grant that by your mercy they may live gladly and faithfully in this holy estate. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Repeat after me. Receive this ring.
As a pledge and token.
Of wedded love.
And faithfulness.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Receive this ring.
As a pledge and token.
Of wedded love.
And faithfulness.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now that Chris and Bea have committed themselves to each other in holy matrimony, have given themselves to each other by their solemn pledges, and have declared the same before God and these witnesses, I pronounce them to be husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. The Almighty and gracious God abundantly grant you his favor and sanctity and bless you with the blessings given to Adam and Eve in paradise, that you may please him in both body and soul and live together in holy love until your life's end. Amen. We continue with the lighting of the Indian candle. Let us pray. Almighty, everlasting God, our Heavenly Father, grant that by your blessing, Chris and me may live together according to your word and promise. Strengthen them in faithfulness and love towards each other. Sustain and defend them in every trial and temptation. Help them to live in faith towards you, in the communion of your holy church, and in loving service to each other, that they may ever enjoy your heavenly blessing. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please stand. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Chris, you may kiss the bride. I now present Chris and B. Cabillus.
I can't wait to live my Oh, you're doing magic now.
Because it made all my dreams come true.